Dear students, good morning to all of you. In the previous class, we studied up to lesson 3. Today, lesson 4, Introduction to MS Excel 2016. What do you mean by MS Excel 2016? It is a spreadsheet package. It is one of the Microsoft Office package. MS Excel 2016. What is a spreadsheet? First you must know. Spreadsheet consists of data and information organized in the form of rows and columns. These spreadsheets are commonly used to perform different kinds of calculations. These are used in various fields such as schools, business organization, and etc. Here you can add graphics, images, charts, and many other useful features in this spreadsheet. Now we see how to start this MS Excel 2016. To start MS Excel 2016, two methods are there. The first method is you click on the start button and the start menu appears. There you click Excel 2016 option. This is one method. The another method is type Excel in the Cortana search box, which is available in the taskbar, and click on the Excel 2016 in the result. Immediately the MS Excel 2016 screen will appear. This is the first screen of the MS Excel 2016. Okay, here you have to click the blank workbook option. And if you click that, the following screen appears. This is the MS Excel 2016 window. In this window, you can see so many letters written here, so many words here. One by one we will see. Okay. These are all known as the components of the Excel screen, Excel window, components of the MS Excel window. The first one is the title bar. You see, this is the title bar. This bar is present at the top of the window and it shows the current file name, Excel file name which you are working now. And here are three buttons given. One is the minimize button. And another one is the maximize button and next one is the close button. So the minimize button is used to hide the MS Excel window from the screen. And the maximize window is used to enlarge the MS Excel window. Next one, the close button. This will close the MS Excel window. Is it clear? Okay. Now we see the next one. Quick access toolbar. In the screen you can see all the components. You see quick access toolbar. The quick access toolbar contains some frequently used commands like save, undo, redo, etc. It is not so clear in this. You can see here book the same figure. Okay, there you can see the options clearly. And the quick access toolbar contains frequently used commands. Okay. Next one is the ribbon. Ribbon contains various groups. In each group, there are different commands are there and they will perform different tasks. Okay. Next one, row and column heading. Row heading, column heading separately given here. Here, row heading means that is horizontal division of the worksheet. Here you see it is written as numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So it is up to 1, it is up to so many. Okay, the horizontal divisions of the worksheet is called the row. The rows are numbered from 1, 2, 3, etc. And the vertical divisions of this worksheet is known as the column. Column means A, B, C, D, E like that. It is given. Okay. And this column is up to X, F, D. Next, you come to the point cell. Cell is the intersection of row and a column. And a cell is the smallest unit in the worksheet. Each cell is denoted by its address. How you are defining the cell? A1, C3, like that. Okay, next one, active cell. The cell with the dark boundary around is called the active cell. That is, highlighted box is known as the cell pointer. And here you can click and type your words or letter. Next one, formula bar. This formula bar shows the characters and formulas that you enter in an active cell. Next one is the name box. It displays the cell address of an active cell. Next one, you see in the right hand side worksheet given. It is like a page in the workbook. It consists of rows and columns where you can enter your data. Next one, workbook. The workbook is the collection of one or more worksheets. The default names of the worksheets are given as, workbooks are given as book 1, book 2 and so on. Next one, status bar. At the bottom you see status bar is there. It is located at the bottom of the Excel window. It displays the current status of the cells and the zoom option. Zoom option is also there in the status bar. Next you see sheet tab. Sheet tab means which sheet you are working, whether you are working in worksheet 1 or worksheet 2 or worksheet 3. And if you want, you can insert so many new worksheets in an Excel document. So the current sheet is the active sheet. Is it clear to all? Now we pass on to the next one, range of cells. In the figure you see selecting a range of cells. So here you select or highlight a block of cells. That is known as the range of cells. That is, neighboring cells, then the area formed by the block of cells is known as the range of cells. It looks generally like a square or rectangle, and after selecting the range of cells, you can cut, copy or move the range of cells to any place. Okay, thank you students.